Now let us talk about inserting video clips. Video clips add liveliness to the presentation. PowerPoint allows you to insert a video onto a slide and play it during your presentation. This is a wonderful feature to make your presentation more engaging for the audience. Select the Insert tab. Click on the video drop-down arrow in the Media group and select the video on My PC option. The Insert Video dialog box appears on the screen. Locate and select the desired video file, then click on the Insert option. The Format and Playback tabs appear under the Video Tools tab on the ribbon. You can format the inserted video by clicking on the Format tab and selecting various formatting options from it. Click on the Play button present either below the video clip or at the extreme left of the ribbon. The video will start playing. The timeline next to the play button will begin to advance. Click anywhere on the timeline to jump to any part of the video. Now let me give you a tip. In PowerPoint 2016, you can also embed videos from websites like www.youtube.com into your presentation. You can resize a video by clicking and dragging the corner sizing handles until the video is of the desired size. To delete a video, select it and then press either the backspace or delete key. Students, let me share an interesting fact with you. To make a duplicate of the current slide, press Ctrl plus D key combination. Let us find out how to use action buttons. In PowerPoint, we have the facility to link to a web page, email address, file, slide in the same presentation or in a different presentation. This can be done using hyperlinks and action buttons. Action buttons are built-in shapes which you can add to a presentation and set a link to another slide, play a sound, or perform some other action. You can also assign actions to clip art, pictures, or the text in SmartArt Graphic. When one clicks or hovers the mouse pointer on the button, the selected action will occur. Open an existing presentation. Select the Insert tab and click on the Shapes command in the Illustrations group. Select the desired action button from the Actions button category present at the bottom of the displayed list in the drop-down menu. For example, click the Action button, go to End option. The mouse pointer will change into plus shape. Click and drag the mouse diagonally. As soon as the mouse button is released, the Action Settings dialog box will appear containing two tabs, namely Mouse Click and Mouse Over. By default, Mouse Click tab is activated. The Mouse Click tab makes the action button perform its action only when it is clicked, whereas the Mouse Over tab will make the action button perform its action when you move the mouse over it. In the Action on Click section of the Mouse Click tab, select Hyperlink to Radio button, then click the drop-down arrow and choose any option from the menu. For example, Previous Slide, First Slide, or Last Slide, etc. To link to a file created in another program, click on Other File from the Hyperlink to list. Select the Play Sound checkbox if you want a sound to play when an action button is clicked. Choose any sound either from the drop-down menu or select Other Sound option to use a sound file present on your computer. Click OK. Now press F5 to view the slideshow. Click on the action button during the slideshow and observe the action. Students, note that action buttons should not be inserted on master slides. You can insert an action button on a slide if required. Let us now learn how to import data from Word. PowerPoint provides the facility to import data from other applications like Word, Excel, etc. and use it in the presentation. Importing data saves your time and efforts. Follow the given steps to import data from Word file. Click on the Start, then go to All Apps, then go to Microsoft Office, and then go to Word 2016. Create a new document. Select the View tab, then click on the Outline button in the Views group. Type the text as shown in the figure. Now click on Close Outline View button to return to the Print Layout view. Select Types of Software and apply Heading 1 from Styles group on the Home tab. Select Microsoft Word and choose Heading 2. Select Microsoft Excel and apply Heading 3. Similarly, applying Heading 1 on CorelDRAW and Heading 2 on Corel Photo Paint, Flash and Adobe Photoshop. Save the file with the name Types of Software and exit from Microsoft Word. Start PowerPoint and open any existing presentation. Click on the View tab and select the Slide Sorter button. Now click on the New Slide drop-down menu on the Home tab. Select the Slides from Outline option. The Insert Outline dialog box will appear. Browse the location of the Word file, Types of Software. Select the file and click on the Open button. Observe that two new slides will get inserted and display the text in a style which you have applied. Students know the fact that a hyperlink is a connection from one slide to another presentation or any other file or any website or web page. It can be applied on text or objects such as pictures, shapes, etc. Students also know that in PowerPoint 2013, you can apply transition effects and animation using the Transitions and Animations tab in the same way as we do in PowerPoint 2016. Students, let us now learn how to share presentation online. Open a presentation which you want to share and click on the Share button present on the top right corner of the ribbon. PowerPoint will prompt the option Save to Cloud if you have not saved your presentation yet. Choose the location OneDrive Personal to save your presentation. Once your presentation is saved to the shared location, click on the Share with People option from the Share window. The Share task pane will appear in the presentation window. In the text field under Invite People, enter the email address of the person you would like to share with or select the email address from the address book if the contact is already saved. Select the option Can Edit if you want the other person to work on the presentation simultaneously. Otherwise, select Can View option below the Invite People list. Now click on the Share button. Students, note the fact, to print a slide with the default settings, click on the Print option in the File tab menu.